الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت: إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: ما من يوم أكثر من أن يعتق الله فيه عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة، وإنه ليدنو ثم يباهي بهم الملائكة فيقول: ما أراد هؤلاء؟ أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد، وعلينا معهم. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد، وعلينا معهم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي، رب زدني علما. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. My dear respected brothers, elders, Hufaz, Ulama Kiram, brothers and sisters listening at home, last week we were discussing the first 10 nights of the Dhul-Hijjah, how these 10 nights and 10 days are blessed in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has took an oath in Surah Al-Fajr at the beginning, and then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also in his ahadith has discussed the virtue of these first 10 days, that throughout the year when a believer worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is beloved to him. However, in these first 10 days, the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the focus and the mercy and the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is towards the believers even more in these first 10 days. The ulama explained that the first 10 days in the aspect of the days are more beloved than even in the days of Ramadan. However, the last 10 nights of Ramadan are more beloved than the first 10 nights of Dhul-Hijjah. So the first 10 days, if a person is to fast, each fast is equal to 355 days, which is the number of days in our Islamic calendar. So if a person, alhamdulillah, fasted for the last 8 days, he has earned the reward of fasting for 8 years. And like this, each night is equal to the night of Qadr, Laylatul Qadr, which is more than 83 years. So this is the season of sales. Generally, when we know that the Black Friday is coming close, Boxing Day is coming close, or other sales are coming close, we wait for those moments. Either we go to the shop itself in person, or we wait online that as soon as the sales start, we're ready there to start shopping. Why? Because we know that what is, for example, out of this sale season is worth 30, 40, 40 pounds. In season, we'll get it for half price, maybe 60% off, maybe 70% off. £5, £10, £20, we know that we can save 20, £30. But this is the sales of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the season where the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends and our reward are increased. The focus towards us even more by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we've had the first 8 days. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whatever ibadat that we have done, if we have fasted, we may have prayed our Isha Salah and Fajr Salah with the Jama'at, we may have woken up for Tahajjud Salah, we may have done Tilawat in the night time, we may have done Dua, any other forms of worship. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all types of worship that we have done in the last 8 days. And also if there's any deficiency, if there's any faults, then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our shortcomings and those faults as well, and overlook them and not to consider them, not to look towards them, and just shower mercy, His mercy towards us, and He accepts all types of ibadah. And also, for those who may have not done, who may be thinking that, you know, only if I did this, only if I did this, it's still not too late. Today is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah. Today is also a special day. There are blessings upon blessings upon blessings today. Tomorrow is also a special day as well. So we've still got one full entire day, and today the rest of the day as well, where we can gain something. Where we can gain something. So you haven't completely lost, we still can gain something, inshallah. So today is, as you know, first of all, the best day of the week is Jumu'ah day. Friday for a believer is like an Eid day. It's like an Eid day, it's a celebration day. So Friday itself is already blessed. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends already on the Friday throughout the year. Throughout the year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is towards us. And then on top of that, these are the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, as you mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has took an oath on these 10 days. And whenever He takes an oath on something, it's to show the importance and the value of that object or that thing. So by taking an oath on these first 10 days, we understand how important it is to in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So secondly, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has took an oath on these first 10 days. And next point is that today is the day of Arafah as well. And Arafah itself is already blessed. Many ahadith and in the Quran as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has took an oath وَشَفْعِ وَالْوَطْرِ on the day of Arafah, on the next day of Eid as well. So these few points already bring the importance and the value of these 10 days, and especially today and tomorrow as well. So whatever ibadah we have done, we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His acceptance, that Allah accept it. And ask for ability to continue that for the next today as well and tomorrow and for the rest of our life as well. And if we have not managed to do much ibadah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for our shortcomings, forgiveness for our weakness. But then we make plans. And how can I make the most of the rest of the day today? How can I make the most of the rest of the day tomorrow as well? So by making a plan, making a timetable, making a schedule, then inshallah we'll be able to achieve and gain most and maximum benefit of these 2 days. Now one reason why today Arafah day is blessed is Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explains in hadith that throughout the year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if a person was to turn towards Him and ask for freedom from Jahannam, ask for forgiveness, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive that individual. In the month of Ramadan, that number also increases. But today is the day where a large amount of people will be freed from the fire of Jahannam. A believer, he has iman. He believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He believes in the akhirat. The fundamental beliefs are there. But as a human being, he will slip. He may commit a sin. He may commit a sin. So by committing a sin, and a person, what will happen is that depending on the sin, he takes himself towards Jahannam. He takes himself towards the Jahannam, and his name is written in the register of those who are going to be in Jahannam. On this day, if a person was to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was to say that, oh Allah, I have done X amount of sins, I have done this number of sins. And then a person, he has that regret, he has a sorry feeling inside himself. That for example, I have not been praying my salah with the jama'at. I have not been praying my salah at all. This is a sin, this is a major sin. Like this, if a person looks into himself and he thinks that, you know, I've been deceiving people, I've been lying to people, I've been disrespecting my parents, I've been, you know, committing other types of sins with the eyes, with the ears, with the hands, etc. So if a person has this a list in front of him, and then he turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today, and he turns to Allah and he says that, oh Allah, I'm asking for forgiveness from this sin. I'm asking for forgiveness from these sins. And he makes a list that I have done this sin, I have done this sin, I have done this sin. And then he asks for forgiveness. And at the same time, he makes a firm intention and a firm resolution that I will not go towards these sins anymore. I will not go towards lying. I will not go towards deceiving people. I will not go towards any fornication, any types of fornication. I will not go towards gambling. I will not go towards listening to music. I will not go towards lying. And the list, a person will understand himself that what sort of sin that he has in his life. So he makes that intention. He seeks forgiveness, and a firm resolution. So when these few points are there, regret and remorse, repent, and never to return to that sin again, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will today, if the name is written in those people who are going to Jahannam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to remove that name of that person and put it into the name of, in the register of those people who are going to Jannah. So today Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is towards us so much, is in abundance, so much in abundance that He is ready to forgive and free a large amount of people from the fire of Jahannam and put them into the list of Jannah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does this. Now on this day as well, the hadith explains that وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَدْنُوا ثُمَّ يُبَاهِي بِهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends, it comes down. Now what this means is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. What does He mean by Him descending to the first heaven? What does He mean by this? We don't know. Now we read Alif Lam Mim many times in our life, but we do not know the correct meaning of Alif Lam Mim. There are certain things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept the meaning for Himself. He has not revealed it. Even if you look in the life of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, He never asked, what does it mean by you descending into the first heaven? So we shouldn't object that what does this mean, or could it mean this, could it mean this? We are not there to discuss all these matters. These are the secrets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does it mean by Alif Lam Mim? What does it mean by وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَدْنُوا بِهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ لَيَدْنُوا بِهِمْ, that He comes down. What does He mean by that? We should just leave it, the meaning, the correct meaning, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then on the day of judgment, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to explain, then He will explain. So He turns towards us. ثُمَّ يُبَاهِمِ بِهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Then He looks at the angels and He says that, look at these people. Today is the day of Arafah. They have turned towards me. And those who have gone for Hajj, they will be in the Ihram. They will be as travelers. The hair will be disheveled. And they will be like this, in this way, they will be turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will boast and He will ask the malaika, that what do these people want? What do these believers want? Whatever they want today, they will be given. They will be given. So today is the day where if you look at the Hujjaj, they will be in the plains of Arafah. So this blessing of day of Arafah, remember, is not just for those who have gone for Hajj. The blessing of Arafah, the day of Arafah, is not only for those who are in Hajj. But the blessing of the day of Arafah is general. It's for everybody. It's for the entire ummah. It's for the entire Muslim ummah around the world. So not only for those who have gone for Hajj. Yes, those who are in Hajj, they will be turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can also do that in our own homes, in our own time, and today, where we can turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we do this, then we will also earn that blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to today. So then He makes an announcement that those people, whatever they want, will be given. So those Hujjaj, when they seek forgiveness for themselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive them. And whoever they seek for forgiveness for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also forgive them as well. So for us, those who are at home, we may not be in the plain of Arafat, in the land of Arafat, but we are at home, we should also take maximum benefit of today as well and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for freedom from the fire of Jahannam. So that's number one. Number two, on this day, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explains that the khayru du'a, the best day of making du'a is the day of Arafah. The best day of making du'a is the day of Arafah. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that on this day, myself, when nabiyuna min qabli, and also the prophets, messengers who came before me, they did the du'a. And the du'a they were doing on this day of Arafah is, as we know in the part of the fourth kalima, is La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ يُحْيِي وَلَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. So لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. So this is the dua of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the prophets before. So if we were to recite this and make dua using these words, it's not only done by Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it is also done by the prophets that had come before as well. So this is a time where we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, you know, to sit for dua, at times we struggle. We sit there for a few minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and we go completely blank. Now the way to do that is, Mufti Abdul Rahman Mangera explained, Sahib, that take today as a blank check from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's like a blank check. You can write as much as you want. So sit there making dua. And the, before you make dua, make a list. Make a list. Whatever is coming to your mind, make a list of that. And then make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After you've made dua, you've gone blank, you've gone tired, you know, you're tired. Do some other ibadat. Maybe take the Quran out, do tilawat of the Quran, take the tasbih, do the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, read durood sharif. Then in the middle you remember, oh, I need to make dua for this. Make, note it down, or turn to dua straight away. So you're making dua, you finish making dua, you do other forms of ibadat, then you remember a few other things. Again, you turn to dua, you make dua for until you're able to do so. Then you go back to another types of ibadat. Then again, you remember something else that, oh, I need to make dua for this. Again, you turn to dua. So you today spend as much as time as you can in making dua. As we said, it's like a blank check. You can get as much as from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today. You know, there are akabir, there are pious people, probably now in our days as well, who spend hours and hours, 6 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours in making dua. You know, sometimes you think, as you know, youngsters especially, that how can a person stay in making dua for 6 hours in one go? It's very simple, very simple. If you were to give them a game, if you were to give them a tablet or an iPad or something, they will sit there for hours and hours without even realizing how much time has gone by. Why? Because they enjoy it. The focus is there. They're attached to that thing. They're attached to it. So when their attachment is there, when that the zeal is there, when the interest is there, a person can spend hours behind it. Like this, we need to build the attachment to the dua. We need to make attachment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we are attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we can spend the hours and hours making dua. Manana Bilal Sahib Damat Barakatum, yesterday he mentioned that Hafiz Patel rahmatullahi alayhi, once a mufti from Canada, he came to visit him. And it was evening time, Isha time. So Mufti Sahib said to Hafiz Patel rahmatullahi alayhi that I want to stay in your khidmat. So he said, okay. So he said, okay, let's fix a time that what time do you want me to wake you up? So I'll wake you up at that time. So he fixed the time that, okay, wake you up at this time. So this Mufti Sahib was sat there in his tasbih and he thought, chalo, there's not time, not long to go. I'll sit for a short while and I'll be awake at that time to wake him up. Unfortunately, he fell asleep himself. And when he opened his eyes, he realized that half an hour, 45 minutes had gone over the time that he was supposed to wake. Hafiz rahmatullahi alayhi. Then he got worried. He quickly went to look. He wasn't in his bed. He went around looking for him. And then he found him in one room making dua. So he thought, let me sit down. I need to say sorry to him that, you know, I didn't wake you up. So he goes, I sat down. And it was a couple of hours left before Fajr Salah. So he's making dua. And after the dua finished, he continued his dua till Fajr Salah, Fajr Azan. After the dua finished, I went to him and I saw forgiveness that, you know, I'm sorry that I didn't wake you up on time, the time that we did agree. Then after that, he said to Hafiz Patel rahmatullah alayhi that, you know, the dua you made, the dua was that, oh Allah, forgive the ummah, have mercy upon the ummah, and also solve the matters of ummah. And this was his dua for them few hours. So he said to him that, you know, this dua, you spent the whole night in making this dua. So he said, for the last 35 odd years, I've been spending the entire night in making dua for the ummah. Entire night in making dua for the ummah. So today is the day where we can...
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
Just to conclude, there's a few things that we should try to do today to gain the maximum benefit of the day of Arafah and the day of Jumu'ah. Number one, recite La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir 100 times, read Suratul Ikhlas 100 times, and then the Durood Ibrahim, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid wa alayna ma'ahum. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وعلينا معهم. This also 100 times. And most important thing we should do is we should refrain from sins. Make it today free from sins day. Free from sins day. Inshallah, if you do this, then the hadith explains that and the last, our previous sins will all be forgiven. Not only last 1 year, previous sins. Since the time of Bulughat, since then all of our sins will be forgiven. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to practice on these 3 points and give us the maximum benefit of today. Fill in the rows from now and the gaps, so those who are coming after.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد
الله أكبر 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 لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد إن الحمد لله الذي أتاح لنا يوم عرفة نحمده تعالى ونشكره على ما أنعم علينا بنعمة الإسلام والقرآن فأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله سيد الأنام صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الكرام أما بعد فيا معشر المسلمين أوصيكم ونفسي أولاً بتقوى الله عز وجل وطاعته والتمسك بسنة حبيبه صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أيها المسلمون لقد اجتمعت في هذا الأسبوع فضائل متعددة منها يوم عرفة ثم يوم النحر ثم هو يوم العيد وأيام الأضحية والتشريق أما يوم عرفة فيوم شرفه الله عز وجل وعرفه يوم الغفران والعتق من النيران وبشر بذلك الرسول صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أمته بقوله صيام يوم عرفة إني أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي بعده والسنة التي قبله وقال العلماء هذا لغير الحجاج فيكره الصوم في ميدان عرفات لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يصم في الوداع كما أخبرنا نبينا المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم في فضل الحجاج في يوم عرفة حيث قال ما رؤي شيطان يوما فيه أصغر ولا أدحر ولا أحقر ولا أغيظ منه يوم عرفة يكفي لفضل يوم عرفة أن الله تعالى أكمل فيه للمسلمين أحكام دينهم وأتم نعمته من الإسلام وجعل نبيه خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين حيث أعلن سبحانه وتعالى اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا يقول عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه والله إني لأعلم المكان الذي نزلت فيه واليوم الذي نزلت على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عشية عرفة في يوم الجمعة حيث أمر الله بقوله تعالى واذكروا الله في أيام معدودات وهي أيام التشريق ويقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أيام عيد الأضحى فمن سنة العيد أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان لا يخرج يوم الفطر حتى يطعم ولا يطعم حتى يوم الأضحى حتى يصلي لذلك عباد الله أرشد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمته إلى التضحية وحرضهم على ذلك بقوله من كان له ساعة ولم يضحي فلا يقربن مصلانا نسأل الله التوفيق لما يحب وترضى من التضحية في الأموال والأنفس في سبيل الله عز وجل أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الله أكبر 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 لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد وقد أمرنا الله عز وجل أن نصلي على نبيه الأجمل فقال تبارك وتعالى إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد وقد أمرنا بالصلاة عليه بالسنن والآيات فمن صلى عليه 10 مرات كان له عدل 10 رقاب من صلى عليه 10 أو أكثر أمنه الله يوم الفزع الأكبر من صلى عليه عند دخول بيته وسلم وسع الله عليه رزقه وأنعم من صلى عليه في ذلك المجلس كفر الله من اللغة في ذلك المجلس من كتب الصلاة عليه في الكتاب لم يزل في أجر وثواب ما قرئ ذلك الكتاب فمن أحب وجهه الكريم كان معه في جنات النعيم إلهنا وإله حبيبنا نسأل منك مرافقة نبينا وحبيبنا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم في الفردوس الأعلى ونسأل مرافقة الذين كانوا مع النبي الأكرم الذين كانوا معه بمكة في دار الأرقم ونسأل مرافقة المهاجرين والأنصار والذين تبعهم بإحسان من أبي بكر وعمر وعلي وعثمان ومرافقة الذين كانوا معه في الغزوات وبدر وحنين وأزواجه وأهل البيت والشيخين والختنين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. Brothers are kindly requested to stand shoulder to shoulder, fill in the rows in front, the space on the right side of the Jamaat color.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تأكلوا الربا أضعافا مضاعفة واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون
واتقوا النار التي أعدت للكافرين وأطيعوا الله والرسول لعلكم ترحمون وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يوم لا يخزي الله النبي والذين آمنوا معه نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The collection today is for those Muslim brothers and sisters and children and families who have been affected by the floods in Assam, floods in Bangladesh, and also the earthquake in Afghanistan. So all the brothers are kindly requested. These are the days where we can earn a lot from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by helping others, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us as well. In the days of happiness, if we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we make dua to Allah, we spend in the path of Allah whilst we are rich and healthy. Then in the days of difficulties, in the days of hardship, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help will also be with us as well. So all the brothers are kindly requested to donate generously for these three appeals. And the next announcement is, inshallah, tomorrow, the Eid Salah in our masjid, inshallah, will take place at 7:45. The Eid Salah will take place at 7:45. And inshallah, the bayan in Urdu and English will commence around 7 o'clock. Will commence around at 7 o'clock. Jazakumullah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa Allah. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم صل على محمد ابنك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين نستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليك اللهم نقينا من الذنوب كما نقيت الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا اللهم ارزقنا نستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليه اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار اللهم أجنا من النار اللهم أجنا من النار اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر ونعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا به وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا به وما لم نعلم جزا الله عنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ما وعنه ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وأرنا مناسكنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم سبحان ربك رب العزة ما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا رب.